to leave behind footprints on the sands of time. A very good morning to everyone, respected Principal Ma'am, Swamiji, and all the teachers. I, Surbhi Anand, on behalf of Vivekananda Society, welcomes you all in this talk. Swami Vivekananda said, "I can never teach you anything. You will have to teach yourself. But I can help, perhaps, in giving expression to that thought." Now, we would like to facilitate Swami Paryanand with a bouquet and a token of appreciation. I would like to request Principal Ma'am to please present the bouquet to Swamiji. Thank you, Ma'am. Vivekananda's preachings are kept in life by the speakers like ours. Now, I would like to give a brief introduction to the speaker, Swami Paryanand. Sir Paryanand joined RK Mission in 2004 and served in Vijayawada, Hyderabad, and also in Calcutta, branches of RK Mission, and now in Delhi. He delivers lectures every week in Vivekananda Youth Forum for RK Mission and lectures to around thousands of students from 6th standard to PG and at hundreds of colleges. I would like to request sir to please come.
श्री यतिराजाय विवेकानंद शूरये सच्चित् सुखस्वरूपाय स्वामिने तापहारिणे. गुड मॉर्निंग, स्लीपी मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग. ओके, आई एम योर ब्रदर. दिस इज व्हाट आई वांट टू टेल यू इन द फर्स्ट लाइन, सो फील फ्री. एज द इंट्रोड्यूसर टोल्ड, quoted Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda himself says, "I cannot teach you anything, I can only make you realize what you are." Okay? Or whatever you want to teach yourself, we can only facilitate. We, any teacher in the world, any good teacher facilitates. Bad teachers, what they do? They try to cram things in our minds and brains. My name is Swami Parayanananda. Introduction was given, and then I want to make this session little dialogue oriented. Do you like, there are two methods of doing this. I can keep on speaking, or you can speak and I can speak. Which is better? Second one or first one? How many for first one? So all of you are for second one? I'm asking you.
Yes.
Second one. Okay, so you need to speak up. I'm going to ask you some questions. What is life? I'll state that I'm not going to speak anything religious here, not politics or anything. Okay? We can talk some basic things. What is life? Is it not relevant to us? We are living, right? How many are? Raise your hands. Oh, only these? Are you leaving? You all have hands first? If you have, please. Oh, yeah. Thanks. So we are leaving. What is life? I just want to know, all students here belong to philosophy department only or no? Philosophy. Yeah. So what is life? If you ask the science person, then they will say, oh, that's not my subject. Now, if you respond quickly, I'll finish this quickly. So you punishment for 1 hour, 1.5 hour, hands faster. Oh, great. You all silent? Your friend answered. What should we do? Can we have claps? You know how to clap, right? You know, when I used to speak to children in Andhra Pradesh, I belong to Andhra Pradesh, my mother tongue is not Hindi, so you have to forgive me if I don't use Hindi, etc. My Hindi, even if I use the gender and vachan, it goes here and there, so it will be very funny. I don't want to do it. In Andhra Pradesh, when I went to very poor schools, where poor students study for free government schools, they taught me about 10 various methods of clapping. I learned from them. You know, so many ways are there. Anyway, I forgot all about them. And there are other ways. Now I don't want to dwell on that. I've got long agenda for 1.5 hour almost. So, she answered first amongst all of you. Did she do something good, better than you all? Yes or no? So, if we appreciate, is it a favor that we are doing to her or me or to yourself? To ourselves, why? Yes, other person has made an effort and before I did, she did it, right? So, you want that quality? You want to be quick? Then if you want the quality, a good quality in others, how do you invite the quality in yourself? How do you invite the quality? By appreciating first. When you appreciate, what happens, that quality in the other person knows that, okay, here I am invited, I can go into this person also. And then that good quality is transferred to you also. So it is beneficial to you, your brain and minds or hearts are expanded by doing this. Okay. Swami Vivekananda says expansion is life, contraction is death. Should you not be expanded? Where so many discriminations in the world, there, you know, various kinds of discrimination, poor and rich, black and white, yes or no, so many kinds, east and west, north and south, so many kinds of discrimination. Your religion is different, my religion is different, so you are different. Is that expansion or contraction? Is it narrowness or broad-heartedness? Yeah, narrowness. So, if we expand ourselves, so for me, okay, you tell me, what is life? You answered, can you please answer again? Yeah, life is full of desires. Okay, one answer, second answer. Life is what you make out of it. Second, third. Okay. Learning things. And then what happens? We just learn. And then, well, shall we apply or not? And teach others. And then, get out of life, right? Right? Any other answers? Yes? Life is a journey from where to where? To death. Even if you don't think like that, you're forced to do that, right? You're forced to undertake this journey. Do you want to be forced? By anything. So what shall we do? We don't want to be forced. Is that sharp enough? Okay. Can we switch off these two lights? Yeah. I didn't want to be forced. I want to have absolute control over my life, okay? That is why I chose one path. I'm not suggesting that this is the only path, okay? Now, was asked my qualification when Supriya came, and then just for introduction, etc. I did not study much, because most of the times what happens is your education is something and what you end up doing is something else, right? How many times in 100? 99 times. So I understood that. I understood even while I was studying. So maybe I will also not be able to do it. 1 minute. I'll show you one. You know this guy? You know this person? Who is he? Rowan Atkinson. He is known more like Mr. Bean than as Rowan Atkinson. Yeah. Is it, will you come here? You read that? Has master's degree in electrical engineering? From Queen's University. What is he paid for? Right? Steve Jobs, what is his qualification? Masters? But he was a dropout, right? So, yeah. There is so much difference in what you are studying and what you are doing in life. So my ambition was, can anybody guess? To apply what I have studied? No, sorry. That's not my ambition. Why guesses? No problem. Don't be afraid to be wrong. If you are afraid to be wrong, you are doing nothing new. No. That's a very good answer. Very good guess. No problem. No, what is my ambition? Ambition. You're talking about... Yeah, to live my life to the fullest. I'll tell you what. I'll tell you like this. I want to become infinite. You know what infinite is? What is infinite? Endless and no limits, no boundaries. Yeah, simple. I have limits, I understand that. Do I have limits or not? I can't be at once here and also there. I'm limited by space. I can't be at once today and tomorrow also, because I'm limited by time, right? I'm limited by causation, right? If there is a slab, okay, and the brick falls right on a spot, I'm going to die at that moment, right? So there is a cause, there is an effort, there is a effect. I'm bound by that. I don't want to be bound by anything. I want to have absolute control of my life, of my body, of my mind, everything. So I questioned about it, and I want to do that. And I thought our education system has no answer for this. In the sense, the conventional education system which we find, what is our education system? Can be seen in this. Here, you see this? You must have seen this, right? How many have not? Raise your hands. Yeah, read it then. What's our education system? The teacher says, for a fair selection, everybody has to take the same exams. Please climb the tree. Right? I thought, it's our education system. Suppose 20 people are there in the class, 20 people are just in the same way. You may be made for painting, you may be made for cricketing, you may be made for becoming a good director or an actor, but you all are forced to do something, only one thing, right? Studies. I'm not saying studies are bad. For most people, 60% or 70%, studies are very good. They can earn a lot of money, they can make a living out of it, and then they are good at it. They're not good at many other things, right? But then there are other people who are not. We need to leave room for that, right? And then that is why I became what I became, but a monk. But then I'm not insisting that any people have to become monks or anything like that. So, I was asked to speak on values and Vivekananda. Why values are important? What are values? Anybody? What are values?
Courage, honesty.
Yes. Why should I follow any value at all? Why should I not cheat? Why should I not be selfish? Why should I not grow at the expense of somebody else? Why? Yes, yes, speak.
The right path.
Why should we be always right? Nobody have a question, right? Okay, right and wrong. You want to be only on the right side, right? Why should it not be left or why should it not be wrong side? Why? Have you questioned that? Everybody told us not to steal. Swami Vivekananda says this. Everybody tells you not to steal, not to tell lies. But they don't tell you why. Why? Why should I not steal? Why should I not tell lies? Because it harms other people, so only social reasons. Suppose I don't harm and I tell lies, they're called white lies. Is it okay? Yeah? Yes, please, yes. Values we have. Only we can appreciate life. So is appreciating life all about our journey? Now, I'll tell you, what is the highest megapixel available camera available in a phone now in the market? 40? Yeah? Well, how much is that in money? 40,000? 30,000? 50,000? Okay. So, do you know that our eye is showing this world every day in about 580 megapixels? Do you know that? This whole world, our eyes are showing us in such clarity 580 megapixels. So, how valuable our eyes must be? And you know, 3D. And nobody advertises us, you know, do you want 3D eyes? Or do you want 2D eyes? Have you paid a pie, one single rupee for that? No. They are given free for us, right? So we don't know the value. Can't you appreciate that? This very fact. Even without becoming a very value-oriented life or something like that, even without that, can we not? It's a great fact to be appreciating, right? We should be appreciating. The whole body, if you put in terms of money, how many crores it must be? Can science make one human body which is so flexible, so agile? Suppose you can make a robot, lifelike robot, right? Robot moves in mechanical way. Can it dance like a dancer? Can it dance like a Kuchipudi dancer or a ballet? No, right? So very beautifully? No. Robots can't compete. So who gave us that? How much valuable is that? And what are we doing with that? Are we using properly to the utmost level or not? And if body itself is so valuable, what is mind? How valuable our mind is? Yes or no? Are you there with me? So mind is much more valuable. Then who is giving us all these things? How did we get? Did we win these things in a race? Or in a lottery? With our hard sweat? Did we earn this? No. We are just put in these situations. Why? So many questions are there which are unanswered. And suppose you are a reasoning person. Suppose you are a reasoning person. Many people claim that I am a very reasoning, rational person. I want to think scientifically, etc., etc. Should you not think that why I have been given this? If you really think, then you will understand. Suppose you have been given a great instrument. Why is this water, bottle of water here? For me to drink, right? So there is a purpose for that. For a bottle of water, if there is a purpose, for such a wonderful body and mind, are there not? Is there no purpose? What must be the purpose? How great and noble must be that purpose? Have you ever inquired what is the mission of our life? Why are we designed like this? This inquiry makes you a philosopher. Not just studying your syllabus, coming first there, writing long answers or... I don't think so. How many of you agree? If you agree, raise your hands. Yes, thank you very much. 100%. Now, this is what made me a philosopher. I never went into a philosophy class. Right? Swami Vivekananda also thought like that. Swami Vivekananda at that time, he, in the British, till 1911, Calcutta was capital, not Delhi, of India. And then he was in Calcutta, and there in British time, there were universities of such great standards. Nowadays, anybody can become a graduate. You know, you finish your degree, anybody can become a... At that time, if you are you become a graduate, it's great thing. It's lots of effort you have to become a graduate. Philosophers, real philosophers from Germany and all these people used to come and teach in British... You know, India is great jewel for India, British Empire. And amongst in that India, Calcutta was capital. And there are so great prestigious institutions there. There, philosophers and professors worldwide, they used to come and teach hard philosophy. No entertaining or anything like that. Okay? There, Swami Vivekananda was, he was a blue-eyed boy in every philosopher's, every professor's eyes. Okay? So, he studied all that. But he was not satisfied. He studied philosophy. He studied so many books, etc. He was not satisfied. He wanted to know the ultimate truth. And Eastern philosophy says that it is God is the ultimate truth. Yeah, somebody was telling me Brahman also you read in your philosophy, right? Shankara, Brahman and all these things. Brahman means God. Okay, what is God? Whether he really exists or not? Can anybody define God for me, please? Whatever definition. You know, you can be very silly, no problem, but please express, that's all. No problem. Sorry? Ultimate path? Ultimate path. Yes. And?
God is God.
Good. God is good. Who is doing the evil things then? God is good. Satan is doing the evil things, right? So there is... No. I'm asking. I'm not making... But yeah, it is a serious philosophy, right? There is a theology, etc. Yes? God? Yes?
I guess God is something which is eternal and there is some power which exists which controls all of this.
Some power that exists. Okay, ultimate power, it's almost the same answer, right? Yeah. And I'm talking about infinity, right? Infinity? God's infinity. That's how I define, right? And then I want to become infinity. Why? I don't like it. I want everything to be under my control, not somebody else's control. And the philosophy says, you are already that. You are already infinity, but you forgot. You forgot. Now Sachin Tendulkar, he knows that cricket is a play, right? Cricket is a game. But in a sport, somebody loses, somebody wins. Yes, it is very common. So when he is going into the field, why is he taking his wicket as so seriously and why doesn't want to give away the wicket easily? Why? Yes. Answer. Wants to win the game, wants to be the best, right? He put himself, nobody pressed these ambitions on him. It was his ambition, right? Still, he knows all the while that it is only play, right? But if he loses the wicket, he is going to grieve, right? He has got tremendous grief, he will become very sad. And so many people become sad. Who created all these rules? Play, we humans, right? Come out of the field, then you think that, no, it is all play, no problem. Yes? But inside the field, you forget that it is a sport. If you remember that it is a sport, what happens? Will there be joy in the sport? If everybody thinks if everybody thinks this is just a sport, I can play as I want, will there be joy? Will there be seriousness? No. Similarly, we forgot that we ourselves are that infinity. And then we are identifying ourselves with this body, with this mind. Suppose I propose this philosophy. This is a theory. I'm not asking you to accept it as it is without salt. But I'm just proposing this theory. How many think it is okay? It is right. Suppose you have you think, right? Very good. Now what happens is, suppose a boy is suffering from high fever. He has got delirium. You know what is delirium? In fever, you lose some consciousness. In a semi-conscious state, you speak something. That is not coherent, right? So in that state, suppose the boy says to his mother, "Mother, I got a trunk." You know, elephants have got trunk, right? So similarly, if the boy says, "Mother, see, I've got a trunk, very nice trunk," then what the mother says? He is seeing that thing. It is truth for him. He is able to perceive it. He is able to touch it in the delirium state. So what does the mother say? No, it's a delusion. You are under a delirium. You are under a condition, medical condition. Because of that you are seeing all this. It's not true. Then what the boy says? I am able to see it. For God's sake, I am able to see it, touch it. Do you say it is not reality? Then what does the mother say? She tries to explain for some time. After that, what she says, you know, "Yes, but my boy, Lord Ganesha was pleased with you. He gave his trunk to you." Then the boy believes it. He is happy with the philosophy. That's philosophy actually for you. Anyway. So he is okay. That's even scriptures. Even the scriptures say that one. Okay. So he is satisfied with that. Whatever we are satisfied with that, we are okay with that. Okay? He thinks that is it. And then after some time, his fever is gone. Then will the trunk be there still? No trunk. And will he try to remember that? Oh, I had a trunk. What happened? Somebody cut it or not? Will he ask that? No. Now he is not in the disease condition. He forgot all about the disease, all about the delirium, all about the trunk, for which he fought so much. Okay. So, in this way, similarly, we were infinite. We are pushed into this finite world of, see, I'm different, you're different, I'm white, you're black, you're wrong, I'm right, you're rich, I'm poor, you're from north and south and all these things, you know, all useless things. You belong to another religion, I belong to another religion, therefore you and I are different. How can I be good to you? You hit me. Why should I not hit you back? Why should I be only loving to you? Yes or not? Are this good? Good. Is it good thinking? No. Still you think like that. Why? We are under this delirium. Under the influence of this disease, okay, we think this is the reality. This is how we must live. That is why we are living like that. Somebody comes and says, suppose this dress, you know, I am wearing, you think what is this weird dress? Like a, somebody may be thinking like an animal in the zoo or something like that. Okay. But if suppose tomorrow some great celebrity wears this, this becomes fashion. Yes? Yes? There was an experiment. I had rings in my college, in the college days. I had two rings. They said, "You are traditional, you are all this, you know, it's all boring, etc., etc." Okay. Then what I did is, I removed one ring. Later on, I saw, after a few months, six people in my college were wearing rings. One year. Because that looked fashionable for them. We imitate and we think we are great. We have no strength or confidence enough to be original. You know, all these great directors, they were original people. Suppose Rahman thought that I can become better hockey player, then what would have we got? We would have got a third-rate or fourth-rate hockey player, and we would have lost a gem in music. Yes? So we need to understand what we are made of, why we are made, and then we need to proceed in that way. This is just an introduction. Why I told you all this? Why did I tell you all this? Because to show you, and myself also, how many things we do not know, how many things we are not thinking consciously every day and night. Are these questions rational, which I talked about? It's a very rational. Suppose there is a sea. Suppose you throw a net, fish net. Fish net has got many holes, right? And the fish net falls on the surface of the water. And then the water in each hole appears different. Suppose the water got consciousness, and then it thinks, the water thinks, the water in this particular hole of the fish net is different from, I am different from you. Okay? You think each portion of water in the fish net is thinking, I am different, I am different, I am different. And the net is removed, what happens? They are all same. One water, right? Where is the difference? Difference was temporary. It came in between. Difference is within time. But the nature of the water, the oneness is timeless. I am making this adventure of dwelling into this philosophy because you are philosophy students. Actually, my agenda is, I didn't even start what I wanted to say anyway. So, these are several things. So what I am saying is, underneath we are all one. Not just underneath, in the surface also, like the water, we are all one. But we think we are different. That is why this quarrel is there. The difference are on the surfaces. If you really go inside, what happens is, we all think we are all one. Then there is no finiteness at all. So I become so loving. Why is Dalai Lama so great? Why is the world thinking that Dalai Lama is so great? Why? Answers please. That will ward off sleep also. Why is Dalai Lama? Is Dalai Lama okay? Good? Huh? Great man? Okay, then why? Because nothing but peace. He wants nothing but peace. Right? He doesn't say that. He has got many followers. He can easily tell them to take up sword and cut the other's throat. Okay, we will also perish, but we will kill so many people and then also we perish. No, he did not take up that. What did A.R. Rahman say? I am trying to be relevant to you because I am trying to quote all these people to make you understand, okay? I follow, I'm little up to date, okay? So what did Rahman say when he got Asgard? The dialogue? Anybody Rahman fans here? Raise your hands please. Oh, very few. A.R. Rahman. Okay, what did he say after he got Asgard? The famous dialogue? Very simply. All my life I had two choices, love and hatred. I chose love, I'm here. Yes? He is in peace, complete peace. You can study, I follow lots of interviews, etc. Because before I joined in 2004, even by then I was a hardcore fan of him. So it stayed on. And then he's really a spiritual person. Anyway, why am I telling you is, it's very hard for him to hate. That is it. Right? So those people are noble. What do you all want to become ultimately in life? Anybody please? Quickly. What do you want to become in life? Quickly.
Happiest person.
Eh?
Happiest person.
Then next. Successful person. Anyway, definitions of success vary. Okay, anyway, leave it.
Satisfied person.
Okay, then.
Prove to be a good example for others.
Good example for others? No doubt. Okay, doctors and engineers, that's all. Not your line. Okay. What, BPO job or something like that? What do you want to become? Fashion designer? I understand that you're philosophical students, but then definitely, maybe it will become a reality within 2-3 years for you after you go out of this college. That you will have to do something else, right? Any other ambitions? How many want to become great? Great people? Raise your hands please. Don't be shy. Just great people. How many want to become great? Whatever you are. Okay, many. Greatness, right? I'm going to tell you the same thing. So let me continue, okay? The same thing comes. Now, let us all resolve that we want to become great. Now, how many of you remember your great-grandfather's name, please? Your great-grandfather's name? One. Two, three, grandfather's father, his name, you remember? Very nice, his father's name? No, okay, one, oh, very good. Maybe two, are you there? Oh, you also, very nice. But so many don't remember, great-grandfather's father's name. Huh? Oh, unbelievable, very good. Now, how many of you heard Buddha's name? Raise your hands, Buddha. How many of you heard Jesus Christ's name? How many of you heard Vivekananda's name? How many of you heard Alexander's name? How many of you have heard Ashoka's name? Very good. Then who are all these people? Buddha is 3,000 years old, right? Jesus Christ was 2000 years old. He is 2000 years old. Vivekananda came 150 years ago. Gandhi's name you all heard. Subhash Chandra Bose's name you all heard. Rabindranath Tagore's name. These people all came 50, 60, 70 years ago, right? And at the same time when your great-grandfather was living, why don't you remember the person's name? Forget about the incidents that happened in his life. His blood is coursing through your veins. How can you forget his name? Your own great-grandfather, not my great-grandfather. I mean, the people who don't remember, I'm talking to them. Yes? And why do you remember those people's name? Buddha, Christ, Vivekananda, Alexander, Ashoka, who are these? Are they related to you?
No.
No, but why do you remember?
Studied.
So, why is our great-grandfather's story not in our syllabus? Why is it not studied in libraries? They are not great, right? These people are great. So, at the end of your life, how do you want to be? Do you want to be in the set of these great-grandfathers who are forgotten? Or you want to be in the set of this Buddha, Christ, Vivekananda, Alexander, Ashoka, and etc., etc., Gandhi, Subhash Chandra Bose? Which set do you want to belong? Second, right? So, how to do it? How, what is the measure? So, okay, first step in my lecture is, I've got 5-6 steps. Now, first step is that we all decided now, today, that we want to become great, we want to belong to the set where we are remembered forever. Hundreds of years at least, if not thousands, right? So that is the first step, first resolution. Yes?
Sir, my question is, when you're talking about greatness, are you comparing it somewhere with fame?
Because yeah, I understand. Because for practical purposes, to reach out to you, to communicate, I can only quote famous people. If I quote infamous people or those great people who are not famous, will you be able to understand?
But
no, right? So for practical demonstration teaching purposes, I am using these names, okay? So, but fame is not equal to greatness. This you should understand. Maybe you will become very great, but fame may not come after you, right? May not. May also, okay? Is that all?
Yep.
Okay. Now, first resolution is, first step is we all decided to become great. Okay. Now what is the measurement of greatness? Anybody, measurement of solids are measured in kgs, liquids are measured in liters. Greatness? By work, how can you measure work? We cannot, right? So let us, whatever, even I'm going to say this, say something, say the answer, but that answer also I'm not claiming that it is absolutely true or something like that. For practical demonstration purposes, for understanding purposes, I'll tell you, if I tell you like this, suppose if I die, or suppose one of us dies, well, how many days or months will we be remembered, or years, by our family members? They cry for 10 days or 11 days, 12 days, okay? They put up a photo and a light there and a garland and agarbatti is there, right? After that, 1 month, 2 months, 1 year, after that what happens? You have a memory. Oh, he was there. Such a nice boy, such a nice girl, right? After that what happens? After 2 years, 3 years, oh, this photo is abstract in the scene, I mean, in the interior designing of my house. So put it in the shelf, right? Okay, if not that, still we have forgotten, right? Max 2 years, shall we fix 2 years? Okay. If suppose a person is living and people want him to be dead, then is he great? Aray, when will he die? If some people think like that, we think about some people that by God's grace let him die, right? Maybe terrorists, etc., etc. So he is not great. He is not a good example. That is one extreme. And suppose you die after some time, naturally you are remembered by your family, people, etc. So that is one example. Suppose Abdul Kalam ji, no, God forbid, but then suppose he leaves the world. Well, he will be remembered about 40 years, 50 years at least, as a very good president of India, as a pioneer in rocket science in India, yes, so many other things. And then suppose some other good people, so 40, 50 years max, right? Suppose a person like Gandhi dies, what happens? Suppose 100 years. 150 years, like that, right? But Buddha died 3000 years ago, still he is remembered. Why? He is great. So, I am trying to drive home a point that we can, at least for this teaching in this class purpose, think that the longer you are remembered, the greater you are. Is it okay? Is it okay? How many say it is okay? The longer you are remembered, you are the greater you are. Okay? So this is the second step in my lecture. First step is we all decided to become great. Second step is the topic of my lecture here is another way to greatness. I am not presuming that you don't know the way to greatness. So you have one way to greatness. You all have. And I am trying to suggest to you another way to greatness. That's all. Right? So in this lecture, in my five or six steps, the first step is that we have decided to become great. We need to leave our impression on the world. Right? Suppose tomorrow we die, nobody remembers. Or the world is not changed. We need to make a difference. Okay? So in the second step, we decided that we will think, at least we will assume that the longer we are remembered, the greater we are. Okay? And here, actually I need to show you a video. I forgot. Let's see this video. Extraordinary. What is the difference between ordinary and extraordinary? The word extra, right? So that extra we need to achieve by hard work, the hard way. Never ever believe people who are going to tell you life hacks. You know life hacks? Do you know what that is? You know, techniques. I'll make you great within 30 days. I'll make you a kundalini, this is a spiritual subject anyway. I'll make you a millionaire. One person, when Vivekananda was in America, one person came and gave a card to Vivekananda and says, I'll make you rich in 30 days. Okay, Vivekananda saw the card. On the card, it's not even printed. He wrote his number, I don't know whether the number was, he wrote his address and name with his pen. And then he gave that. Then Vivekananda said, first get yourself, you yourself get money enough to print your card. And then you can make me a millionaire. That's what Vivekananda said. Right. Anyway, now I'll show you another video, but I'm going to ask you questions after that. You need to answer, so be prepared.
Wait.
Okay. Now, if I did not tell you, how many will answer my questions? How many will try to answer my questions? Raise your hands. Yeah. Actually, I should not have told you that I'll ask you questions later on. While you're watching, generally, wherever I play this video, the hilarious side-splitting laughter, and then people sometimes fall off chairs also. Anyway, but now it did not happen because somebody are alert. Most people are alert that, oh, later on I'm going to have an exam on this. So I need to answer the questions. So you see the video in a completely different way. If it is for enjoyment, you see it in a different way. If it is for education, you see in a different way. So what is happening is, all our lives, we are trying to get the entertainment part of everything, and then we are living on so much education part. That is making you ordinary. That is making you commonplace. If you want that extraordinary, that extra mile you want to go, try to definitely enjoy. You definitely enjoy that, but try also to learn whatever you can. Okay? Life taught me more things than any book, than even Vivekananda. Yes, I can tell you that. I'm definitely a great follower of Vivekananda. I dedicated my life for him. But still, following Vivekananda, never Vivekananda asked that you follow me, you accept everything from me. He always asked his disciples to question, to argue with him, to not agree with him. Okay? Unless originally it comes out from you, whatever truth it is, however much time it takes, only then you accept whatever comes originally from you. Okay? Now, what is the moral you learned from that video? Anybody? Quickly. I'm running out of my time. Unpredictability of life, one. Second thing. See, I allow all wild guesses, wild answers, silly answers, anything. I'm not going to mind. You can make anything. You know, participation is more important. Now, what happened is, we also are not alert in life. Are we alert in life? You are simply angry. Anyway, if you admit so well, then how? You should be alert, right? So I asked you to clap when somebody answers before you. Yes, in the beginning of my lecture. Now she answered. Nobody does. Now this is an exception maybe in this college. I have to ask and get clapped. No, I'm sorry. I'm just thinking. Many times it happens. Let us be alert. Let us play those things as game, right? Is it not fun? Okay, I'll say, how many want to sit right? Sit right. How many want to sit right? Head, neck, and whole backbone in one straight line. Is it good? Do you feel good when you sit like that? No. Some people say. How many nose, please? Raise your hands. Very good. You don't feel good. Accept them. Let us all others try to sit right from now. Okay? It's a challenge. Half an hour. Okay? But it's difficult, right? So, how do we want our life to be? Full of difficulties or with no difficulties at all? Answer please. How many say no difficulties at all? Half, 50%, right? Now tell me, suppose you have 15 crores, 20 crores, 30 crores of money, okay? I made one movie. You can buy that movie and distribute. And then whatever profit, suppose you have got 30 crores, right? The cost is, for me to make the whole movie including everything, is 15 crores. Okay? I want to sell you that movie. You give me 20 crores. You got 30 crores, so you give me 20 crores. Now, if the movie makes 200 crores also, the whole profit is yours. Okay? Now tell me, in my movie, what is happening is, there is a hero. That hero has got no difficulties at all. Whatever he wants, he is getting easily. He wants a car, he gets easily. He wants a girl, he gets easily. He wants a great building, glass building, he gets easily. He wants to get rich, he gets easily. What happens? Will you see that movie? Why not? Will you buy that movie first? I'm going to sell that movie to you. No villain. Because if villain is there, difficulties are there. So no villain in the movie. Right? Then will you buy that movie? Why not? It won't be what? Please participate. Actually, if the wire here allowed, I would have gone everywhere here. I would have made you answer, etc. Please. It becomes boring, right? So there are no challenges. If there are no challenges, are there heroes? How do you become heroes? Swami Vivekananda says, this world belongs to heroes. Always be a hero. Never be afraid of anything. Right? This world belongs to whom? Who are worshipped in this world? Only heroes. Why is Sachin Tendulkar a hero? Why is Rahman a hero? What amount of struggles and challenges they faced. That is the amount of fame they are going to get. That is the amount of money they are going to get. That is the amount of hero worship they are going to get in return. How do you want to be? Life to be. No difficulties now or full of difficulties. Because difficulties are what gives you challenges. And then challenges are going to make heroes out of you. There is a butterfly. You know, caterpillar becomes butterfly, etc. It has to come out of its cocoon. Right? So it is trying badly to come out. Okay? So what happens is one boy saw that. It saw that the insect is struggling a lot. He wanted to help. How does he help? He splitted the cocoon himself. So the butterfly, the caterpillar, which is not yet a butterfly, it came out. Okay? Now, he wanted the butterfly to fly. But there is no fly. There is only butter. It is not able to fly. Why? Its wings are not developed. Why its wings are not developed? You know how the wings are developed? The strength in the wings are developed? When it is struggling, hard. Out of that hard struggle, the strength in the wings is developed. Only then it can fly later on. You remove difficulties, you will become a vegetable. You will soon become, you know what? What do you want to become if everything you are given money? What do you want? Money? You want fame or everything? TV, big bungalow, I'll give you everything. Then what will you do? Have a big cushion sofa so that if you sit here in this level, you will go down in this level. Such cushion, okay? And then have a very big flat on TV, or even better, you will lie down and then you will fix it there on the roof, and then you can see. And then this big packet of aloo chips, you know, in America they have, you know, those big potato chips, and then you keep eating. What happens to you? TV grows flatter and flatter, you grow thicker and thicker, fatter and fatter, right? That's what is happening. In 1990s, TVs were very fat, people were very slim. In 2014, what is happening? TVs are very flat. People are fatter. Yes? So that is what is going to become to you if you want easy life. No. Now, okay. Let us come back to that video. Difficulties come. Okay. Let me continue this. Now, this person who... This first... Have you observed there are weapons in their hands? Well, guns were there. What are those guns for? For entertainment? For show? For fashion? Protection, right? Precisely for such situations. Then why did they not use them? When the lion came, why did they not use? No spontaneity, right? They forgot all about it, right? Now, okay, they forgot. Now everybody ran in their own way. Then what happened ultimately? One person was caught. Everybody else went into protection, okay? And then the one person was caught. And the tree he climbed was very tender, so it came down. Then the lion was waiting for him to fall down and it would eat. Now what the other person did? The friend was safety. The tree he climbed was strong and then he was above. Then what happened? Why did he come down? Is it not risky to come down? Why not? Why did he come down? Why should he save his friend? Why? I was asking you why? Now, here is a life and death situation. This person comes down. He is safe there. If the lion eats, he will eat that person and then the lion goes away. Why did he come down? He wanted to become a hero. Yeah. Very good. Yeah, true. But unconsciously. Maybe at that time he didn't know, but then unconsciously. He wants to become great and noble, right? So what is the steps to become noble? That is how. Is it selfish that he came down or unselfishness? So first thing is, the whole video why I showed is, I'm going to give you a formula today to become great. And to become great people, you need these five basic things. I'm going to tell you about five values. And these five values are very basic, minimum. for you to become great. This is my third step in my lecture, okay? So what are these five values? I'm going to get to it. And if you remember this video remembering is very easy, right? This is a hilarious video. And the sequence also. Now if you remember this video, you will remember all the five qualities. And you remember those five qualities, will you become great? Yes? Are. Doctor gives you a prescription. He will write down all the tablets, right? And if you remember them, memorize them, get them by heart, will your sickness be cured? Then how do you expect that if you remember these values? No. The problem is that in reading, writing and remembering, you know what this education is giving us? Reading, writing, remembering. This is not education at all. Education should be able to give you strength to face the problems of your life. How many people do you know come to me, you youngsters, they want to commit suicide. You know why? 3 affairs over, 4th affair. And that also is gone. So I want to die. Commit suicide. You only have to save Swamiji. Fall at my feet. And they never came to Swamiji for a spiritual reason or anything like that. They are not able to handling their own life problems. And one other person says, I am not able to study. I aimed at 95%. All my life I got 95%. Now I got only 85%. My life is worthless. I am going to die. In Hyderabad there is a tank bunny, there is a Buddha statue, etc. There is a big lake, okay? They go and jump in that. 85%, my God, I never even imagined that I would get 85%. And this fellow, who always got 95%, comes to me and says, I have to save him. I never got 85% even. What is life? You know, it's completely reverse. We are not able to be content with whatever we have. We are not able to achieve peace of mind. Suppose you become millionaire. You don't know how many banks you got accounts in. Okay? Then can you get sleep? Can you sleep? No. BP is there. All your life, childhood, you like sweets a lot. You wanted to eat sweets and you could not get sweets. Then you thought, as a vengeance, I will earn lots of money and then I will buy lots of sweets, rooms full of sweets. And I am going to enjoy. What happens? When at that age, you come, you got lots of money, diabetes. You should not eat. If you eat sweet, 3-4 sweets, gone. Die. You will die. With a heart attack. What is happening? What I am talking is that we are not able to manage our own life, our own problems. Is it not shameful that we have to go to someone else and ask solutions for our own problems? We are not able to stand on our own feet. In spite of doing degrees, PGs, etc., etc. Why? How many situations? I can quote so many things. And how many marriages are succeeding? I have statistics. There are startling statistics. Anyway, I don't want to dwell on these things. But what I am saying is, in life, difficulties must be there anyway. Our education is only teaching us reading, writing and remembering. That's all. Heart, head and hand. These three must be expanded, only then your personality is built. Until you expand those things, you should not come out of the college. You are not worthy to have a certificate or degree. You know, so many people, so many universities are certifying this person as a degree holder. I mean, but they can't manage their own lives. I don't believe in that education system. So I'm reckoning this education system is heart, head and hand. What is heart? You should be able to feel the sadness of the other person. The other person has no food to eat. Millions and millions in India are not able to eat food. And we do so many things in our lives. We waste so much money for a birthday party in Hyderabad. A girl wants 25,000 or 30,000 from a girl of intermediate first year or something like that. So she wants to spend 30,000 or 40,000 just to booze or something like that in a ship. She wants to rent a whole ship and then all friends would be there in the ship. And then they want to go as a vacation on the Hussein Sagar. Okay? That was her problem. She asks her father. Her father says, no, we never celebrated like that, etc., etc. She is very upset there. And she comes to Ramakrishnamat. And then the father also comes to Ramakrishnamat in a different time. And then both tell their own different versions of that. And the father says, see, Swamiji, I'm not worried about money. I can give, but then where will this ultimately lead to? Okay. There is no heart to feel. Then what the Swami said is, you know, we had a program called Seal Your Desire. Suppose you have a desire for a 5-star. What is the 5-star value now? Okay, Dairy Milk Silk. What is the value? 100 rupees? 90 rupees? 120 or something like that. You seal that desire, okay? Now don't purchase it. And keep the money aside. Similarly, for a week, if you can spare, suppose 200 rupees, 300 rupees, Go to a government hospital where burns one patients are there, etc., etc. See them, look at them, and then purchase with the same money what they need, basic foods, medicines, or a blanket or something like that. Okay, and then you go and give them. We practically did it in Hyderabad for your birthday. Okay, that is a celebration of birthday. How you celebrate? With all the money that you would have spent like that, you go and give. Then you know what? These people, these are all youngsters and all good from good colleges, very expensive colleges, etc. They went and did it, and the blessings they got from there, and the tears in their eyes moved them. Then the children themselves understood, the girls or the boys, they themselves understood, what am I doing? Why can I not help so many people with the same money? So you know, that ability to feel, we are missing that. If you are missing out in that, there is no education possible. Real education is not going on. That is hard. What is it? To be able to do, you are feeling. But how to do it? You know, there are so many things intellectually you need to understand. What is a philosophy? You need to have a strong philosophy. Why am I doing this? Why all these questions are there? You need to have that. Then hand also. What is hand means? Efficient way of doing things. You want to do a thing, a particular thing. Suppose a person is, a mosquito is there. You take a cricket bat and will you beat that mosquito? Mosquito flies away, but person gets hurt. How to do a thing? You need to understand that. These three are very important. Now let me come back to this. Now what I was asking, that person, unselfishness was the first quality. With unselfishness, he came down. Okay, and also with what? Why did he come down? Because of the friendship. Friendship is love, okay? That feeling of love. That love. You know, from love what happens? To risk his life, courage is needed, right? Courage is needed. Is it not risking his life? Lots of courage is needed. How do you get courage? How do we get courage? From love. I'll tell you. Suppose a mother is there. The mother is going in a street and then four dogs are barking and attacking, trying to attack her or trying to follow her. She is very afraid. She runs in the street. Same mother, next day, afternoon, when her baby is playing outside, okay, and there is a smart tiger coming, okay, and the tiger is looking to devour the child. What does she do? She is seeing that. What does she do? She was afraid of dogs, so she would be naturally afraid of tigers. Will she run away? What would she do? Save the child. Instead, she will be ready to give her life if necessary, right? That takes a lot of courage. Where did that courage come from? Same coward woman earlier. Where did that courage, from where the courage came? From the love for the child. Love gives you courage. Okay? So unselfishness gives you love. Love gives you courage. Okay? So in that courage, this person went to take risk and then went before the lion. Out of that courage came sacrifice. Naturally, it is a sacrifice, right? His life he is sacrificing. And then now tell me, out of sacrifice what comes? Ultimately, he could save the friend, right? Is it not a service? Saving one's life, is it not a service? Okay? Now, who are remembered? Gandhi is great. Why? Because he did lot of service, right? Buddha did lots of service. Christ did lot of service. Martin Luther King did lots of service. That is why they are remembered. No person, is there any person who never did any service and then became great? Hello? No. So service is utmost needed. So service you do, then now tell me, that friend who was saved, is he not does he not remember this person who saved him all his life? He gave his a new life, right? He is going to remember this person that he saved me from a lion. He is going to remember all his life. According to our previous formula, who is great? How do you measure greatness? How do you measure greatness? The longer you are remembered, the greater you are. The person ultimately became great according to that formula. So to become great, what he had to do? Service. From where did he do service? To do service, some amount of sacrifice must be there. Suppose if mother is feeding her own child. Is it a service? Her own child, is it a service? No, it is natural. It is a duty, something like that. But if she feeds every child in the whole street, is that not a service? That is service. Why? Because it is unselfish. There is sacrifice involved there. Unless sacrifice is involved, there is no service. Okay? So, for that service, before service, what happened? Sacrifice was there. to do any sacrifice, courage is necessary. From where the courage comes? Love. From where the love came? Unselfishness. Now what are the five qualities I want you to remember through this video? Unselfishness, love, courage, sacrifice, service. Can anybody tell? Yes. First, in the same order. Unselfishness. Because the first act was unselfish, right? Okay, unselfishness, love, courage, sacrifice, service. Now these are the bare minimum qualities to become great. And then what happened? That person was remembered. So according to our formula, he became great, right? So these are the ordinary qualities and bare minimum qualities that we need to become great. Okay? Now, the fourth step is planning. To build this building, this auditorium, how much planning must have undergone? Lots of planning. If you ask a civil engineer, he will tell you. Lots of planning in somebody's mind or on paper? Oh, engineer says, the plan is in my mind, you build. No, he will put it on paper, right? To build a building. Now, is the building more important or the life more important? Which is more important for you? So, to build a building, you have so much planning. For life, do you have a plan? How many do you have a plan in writing? Very good one. So without planning, what happens is, suppose you build this building without a plan, what happens? It may collapse. Then what happens? The time you spent to build this building is wasted. The money you spent is wasted. The energy you spent is wasted. Right? So, even in similarly in life, if you don't have a planned life, if you don't have a real plan for your life, all the three, the whole time you spent in your life, the whole money you earned, everything, energy, everything is going to be waste, right? Now you see, how much is involved in designing a plane? Lots of planning, lots of designing is involved. Similarly, I'm only urging you people to plan your life well. How much time you spend with yourself per day? Anybody? Any guess, please? Yes? 25 minutes. How much time? Okay, let us analyze how much time we are spending with our cell phones, how much time we are spending with Facebook, how much time we are spending with our friends. How much time we are giving to something else, and how much time we are giving to our own selves to understand really ourselves, okay? So try to spend more time with yourself to understand you, and try to spend more time to plan, okay? When people come and then they say that, Swamiji, my father wanted me to become a doctor and my friends were all taking medicine, so I also took medicine. 2 years later on, what happened? I understood that it is not for me, and then I want to now commit suicide because I cannot drop out. If I drop out, lakhs of rupees are wasted, and also people will call me drop out all my life. Right? It's a serious problem. We did not plan our life well before, and then what is happening is your career. Now you can't become a good doctor, and you can't become what you want to really become. Yes? Somebody showed me 3 idiots. And they told me that contains a lot of message, etc. That person wanted to become a very good photographer, right? So his father wanted, I think, Madhavan, right? And then his father wanted him to become something else. Okay, ultimately he had to become a photographer, but that is what I am saying. So planning is needed. In that planning, you please write down what is life, definitions, what is life, what is marriage, what is relationships, what is the portion or part of relationship that play, etc. Define everything and then write it down. And then also, at 25 years of age, I should become this. At 30, I should become this. At 35, I should become this. These are long-term 5-year plan goals, okay? And for that, you need to have several short-term goals. Yes or no? Time-oriented short-term goals. Today, I need to finish this. Tomorrow I need to finish this. And what should happen is you should plan so beautifully that if you achieve all the small goals, then the long-term goals must have already been achieved. Right? Suppose there are several birds as in a group in the sky, they are flying. Okay? And all that group looks like a big bird. All the whole group is like a big bird. What is that whole bird made of? It's made of several small birds. Okay. Similarly, our small-term goals must be like one bird. And then our long-term goals must have been achieved. For that, you need tremendous amount of planning. Otherwise, you're going to waste so many things in life. Now, that is planning. And to become great, now in the first step, what I'm talking is planning, foresight, and tenacity. These three are special qualities that are required for anybody to become great. Great. Yes or no? We all wanted to become great, right? I'm talking. Now, foresight. Steve Jobs, you know? Now, this computer is Apple computer. You're able to see? So Steve Jobs is the first person to make a personal computer. When you must have seen the Jobs movie or something like that. There is a movie called Jobs. Okay. So there, when Steve Jobs got the idea that the computers must be, you know how big computers were there at that time? Very big. Okay, only industries, factories, only they could afford. Now when Steve Jobs wanted to make a personal computer, he had a foresight that each person will want a personal computer. Now somebody, if anybody gives you freely a laptop, do you not want? Okay. So you wanted this, now you know, but Steve Jobs know earlier, much earlier. So when he proposed to his computer scientist friend that you please make me a very small computer which I am going to manufacture and then sell. What the computer scientist friend told? You know, first point is to make small things bigger it is easy, but bigger things smaller it is very difficult. But I am going to make it, but who would ever want to have a personal computer? That's what the computer scientist friend thinks at that time. You know, he thought that nobody will want a personal computer, but we all want now. Steve Jobs could estimate that. That is why he became Steve Jobs. Right, brothers? They are failing repeatedly. Yes? Now tell me how difficult it is to fly such a plane. To even conceive that there are no planes at that time in the whole world. But they had the tremendous confidence, tremendous vision, foresight that yes, this is going to be the future. And they failed so many times. Yes, naturally they failed. Okay. And you know what the papers wrote? These two boys, Wright brothers, are wasting lots of money, lots of time, lots of energy. This such a flying technology will not come into the world at least 10,000 years from now. That's what newspapers wrote in bold letters. And do you think how much courage, do they need? That no, I'll make it happen. This will happen. And then they did it. Right? You need foresight for that. Without foresight, can you succeed? Can you become great? No. When Gandhi was trying to say that non-violence method, everybody laughed. They said that, do you think the whole British Empire will shake or will budge for your non-violent theory, etc.? You know, Hitler laughed when Hitler was suggested that there is Indian military also. What? India's military? Army? Hitler laughed. That was the impression people had of India then. Okay, because we were following non-violent. But ultimately what happened? Did he not succeed? He succeeded because he had the foresight that yes, this works. So only then you will succeed. Now tenacity, you know, anybody can define me what is tenacity? Tell the meaning of tenacity. Anybody here please? Tenacity. It's just an English word. You all study in English when you... Yeah, anyway, tenacity is... They say dogged tenacity. He has got dogged tenacity. Suppose there is a bulldog. At night, 1 o'clock, he would catch a thief. There is a thief and then he could catch. Do you think that bulldog will leave the thief? If the thief give offers very good dog biscuits, very good brand dog biscuits, will the dog leave? No. Why? Why does the dog not leave? Because the dog knows that I will not be worthy of my name. My name is dog. Okay, I mean, he thinks that my whole life is waste if I leave the thief now. This is precisely why to catch the thief like this, this is precisely why my owner is feeding me every day. This is my life's purpose. This is the whole goal of my life. If I live for petty biscuits or something like that, if I leave this thief, I better die. So, the dog will die but not leave the thief. If the dog has to leave the thief, it should either be killed or the owner must come and the thief must be tied to a tree or something like that. Only then the dog leaves. Similarly, this amount of tenacity, this is called tenacity. This catching hold like grim death, Swami Vivekananda says, to your ideal. Whatever is your ideal, whatever is your goal, catch that ideal in that way, with that tenacity. Only then you can succeed. Is there any other way? You tell me if there is any other way. Without tenacity you can reach that. Can you? No. So, planning. Tell me what are the three special qualities to become Vedantas? Planning, foresight, tenacity. Okay? This is my fourth step. My fifth step, I'm trying to conclude. I'm trying to make it very fast. My fifth step is, I'm going to tell about some real heroes. You all see real heroes, no? What is the difference between real heroes and real heroes? Real, R-E-E-L. You understand, right? You know, 1 minute. So this girl saw a real hero. She likes one hero, and then she found that hero in her own lift. She is going in a lift, and then she found that hero. Our hero is standing there. Unexpectedly, he came into the elevator. So that's our expression. So much to see the real heroes, right? But there are real heroes. How many of you know Arunima Sinha? Arunima Sinha. Not one here. Oh. Arunima Sinha, Indian. Okay. It's a bad state of things. Very sorry state of things because we don't know Arunima Sinha. But Aishwarya Rai's daughter's name, please. Aradhana. We know that. Aradhana has not even become 10 years old. We know that, but we don't know. I tell you who Arunima Sinha is. Arunima Sinha is the first woman amputee to climb Mount Everest. This is her. Okay? This is Arunima Sinha. I'll tell you what is her greatness. She was a volleyball player in 2011 May. She was a real hero. That is what I'm saying. Okay? She was a volleyball player, national level volleyball player. She is going from Bihar to Delhi, and then in a via train in a general compartment, robbers came at night 1 o'clock. They were robbing everybody. She resisted. She had a gold chain. She resisted the robbers. Robbers got angry. Robbers threw her from the running train out of the train. They threw her, and then she fell on the other track, other railway track. And by the time her head fracture, her head got hit, stones, etc. You can imagine with the thrust, etc., the speed, and it is all darkness, and it is between the stations, it is not a village or anything like that, it is between the stations at night, 1 o'clock. She fell, and with a thud, she fell, and then her both hands were fractured, her one leg, the bone in that became small of pieces. Okay, so spine got fractured, and in that state, immediately there is another train coming. She could not move, and that train ran over one of her legs. She lost one leg. Okay, and because she lost that leg and she is in no position to move at all, she had to be there only, and she did not lose consciousness. If she lost consciousness, she could have not got the pain or anything like that. But she did not lose consciousness, so she had to be there, and she was counting how many trains were passing there. And at that night, at that place, nobody expects a human being there, so the trains were just passing. Nobody was there to help. Till 8 o'clock in the morning, so suppose about 7 to 8 hours, she was there only. And do you know the worst thing is, the toilet water and all the other things, etc., from all the drains, they are falling on her body all over in the face. She was in a position not even to wipe that off because both her hands are fractured badly. That is in 2011 May. 2013 May, exactly 2 years later on, she conquered Mount Everest. That's her there. Now, what is climbing Mount Everest? This is Mount Everest summit, you can see here. Mount Everest has to be climbed like that, and she lost that leg, right? And then when she was in hospital, now the worst thing is somebody saw her at 8 o'clock in the morning, so that was only one person who saw, there was no second person. So what he did is he took a sack or something like that. She is not in a condition to move. He placed her in the sack and then he had to drag. He was not able to carry. So drag her to the nearest hospital. Then the nearest hospital recommended her to be taken to a district headquarters hospital. And then she was Bareilly, I think. She was taken into the Bareilly. This is a real story, not a cinema story. And in Bareilly government hospital, she was admitted. And the condition of then the government hospitals was so bad that the doctors, as soon as they saw that, her leg, train ran over. So the leg is not amputated. It was amputated already. The leg piece is not there or something like that. And then if it is not amputated, if it is not cut, the infection will spread everywhere. So it became a gonorrhea or something. I don't know what they call that. Gangrene. And then it had to be cut. Then what the doctors were talking amongst themselves was that she had ultimately no overhead. See, she's in a very, very bad condition. If immediately we don't cut this leg, she is going to die because the infection will spread. So we have to cut. But unfortunately in this government hospital, we do not have anesthesia. We do not have blood. She overheard. Now, what she says, sir, you are doing for my good. I will not mind, even if you do, I will bear the pain. Please do it immediately, I want to live. So without anesthesia, her leg was being cut. She held the rods of the bed and then she took the pain. Okay? Now, after 6 months, she recovered completely. This leg, she got an artificial leg, and in this other leg, which the bone became small pieces, the iron reinforcement was there, steel rods were there, etc. So many other fractures healed. And then while people came to show sympathy to her, saying that, it has become like that. Why do you want to be sorry? I anyway decided that I want to become great in this world. I wanted to leave my mark. Okay, she was a national level volleyball player and she had lots of dreams. Any girl in that position would be saying, now who will marry me and all this and depression, etc., etc. So many things will come. How will I live? Where will I get money, etc., etc. And that is happening because national volleyball player was like that, then the media showed, and then the media showed that it is a false, railway security failure, etc. The railways were blaming that no, Arjuna Sinha wanted to commit suicide, she had family problems, etc. So it became, because they are counter-allegating, right? So, that was a crisis. So people are pointing fingers at her, not showing sympathy, victimizing the victim. This is called, is the power gone? Or my time up, right? Okay. So what happened is, anyway, all that, she was saying that, I'm going to climb Mount Everest. In the hospital, she was not thinking about all those things. If we were there, we would have become, we would have again and again same thoughts. Every day same thoughts would be there. We should never fall into that circle, vicious circle of thoughts. Okay, please remember that is a great depression. But she is so positive that I want to climb Mount Everest in this, like this, and then I will make a record, then I will become great. And she was not even 21 then. Okay. Now, when people thought, maybe her mind also was deranged. Okay, and then people showed sympathy, etc., outwardly, satirically, etc., etc. But when, as soon as she was discharged, she went to many companies saying that I want to, because a lot of money is involved there, I want to climb Mount Everest. They all laughed at her. She did not reply to them. I mean, laughed at her, but she did not respond. Okay, let them laugh. Tata Group believed in her, they wanted to give money. And then, you know, oxygen cylinders, etc., so many things had to be required. They put money in her. And then she joined an institute. Slowly she started walking, then running, then climbing small hillocks, etc. And, you know, you can understand all that, you know, a lot of bleeding, etc. You can just imagine, I have no time to tell all that. So with all that, she climbed within 2 years, just 2 years, she conquered Mount Everest. The person, 2 years earlier, she could not wipe her own face or the filth all that is falling. She climbed Mount Everest. Arunima Sinha, is she a hero or not?
Yes.
We don't know her. We know Aishwarya Rai's daughter's name. That's the state of things. That's the media here. Do you know that one Indian bought East India Company? You know the East India Company which ruled almost everywhere in the world and ruled us for 200 years, etc. The one Indian, a couple of years ago, he purchased in British as a revenge to our slavery, etc. He purchased that East India Company. Now it is owned by an Indian. That has not become news. We don't know that. At the same time, Sania Mirza was marrying, so that became a great news. In that news, this was ground. Anyway, this is one case. I have got 6 to 7 cases to deal with. I will not tell you. I have no time. There is another Narayanan Krishnan. There is Wilma Rudolph. Anybody knows Wilma Rudolph? Philip Pettit. This one case I will tell you, okay? Now, Philip Pettit is a person. Yeah, man on wire. He is a wire worker. Is it okay? Shall I continue? We have other classes. Okay. This one thing, because I don't want to leave it in curiosity, shall I tell you? No, Philip Pettit. This is Philip Pettit. WTC Towers, right? So this man climbed this WTC Towers, which fell on 9/11 in America. In 1974, this person climbed the WTC Towers, tied a rope from this tower to another tower, and he walked there on that. As wire walkers walk on the rope, he walked there. Here he is. He is somewhere here. Okay, you can see. Now the distance between the two towers there in air is 200 feet. 200 feet, 1350 feet high, 120 stories. From there if you look, you know the world looks in a different way. I don't have that photograph. A very small, even big skyscrapers are very small there. At that place, with the wind etc., you can imagine one person, that was his passion, that was his dream. In life he wanted to become that. And then he was walking. You think, how much amount of concentration is needed, focus is needed when he was walking there? What percentage, please? Percentage? 99? 100%. What happens? Otherwise, he falls. And he falls to death. It is not a cinema where there are necks, etc. There are cushions underneath. It is being shot in a different way. Loops are there. No. He's a real hero. So he did it there. Now, do you know how many times he walked? 8 times from this side to that side, that side to this side, this side to that side, that side to this side. He did not want to come down. He was living his life there. He was enjoying it. and he was completely 100% focused, and he was enjoying. He was walking on in the sky there. 45 minutes he was on the rope. Now 44 minutes 59 seconds he was completely 100% focused, and then that 1 second, if he is not, what happens? He's going to die. He knows that. He's a human being. He did not come with special faculties. He trained himself. He trained his body. He trained his mind. And then he was so courageous, so confident that he is able to do that. Do you know what happened ultimately? It is illegal to do that. So, stealthily he went at night. By morning with some of his friends, he tied that rope. And when he was walking, people saw, people were wondering. And then police came. And the police man, when he was coming towards one building, then the police man said,
sir, you have to come down. Then he just smiled at him, he turned back and he was still walking. His passionate about it. That's his life, that's his everything. As we also need that spirit that whatever we decide, we need to do that. Now what happened is ultimately they threatened that they will bring a helicopter and then remove him from there. Only then he had to come down. And then he was arrested. He was asked, why did you do it? Then he said, there is no why. I am passionate about it. I did it. Okay. Now this is what we need. Earlier to that day, I'll just tell you and then I'll come to you. Earlier to that day, he was questioned by his friend. I know you are a great wild walker, but please don't do it. There is suicide. Okay. So then what he said is, the whole my life I spent dreaming this. Even if I fall down from there, it is glorious to die like that. Yes or no? How will you die? He questioned, how will you die? You will die with BP, sugar, cancer, sneezing, coughing in your bed. I will die like a hero, achieving what I want. Is that not great? And that is first answer. Second answer he said is, I am not going to die tomorrow. He is so confident. We are not confident if the exams are there tomorrow. He is so confident, he is saying that I am not going to die because I prepared. You are seeing the task, right? I prepared 8 times that task. My body and mind, I trained. Every day, hard work, with great hard work. I trained with lots of time spent. I trained myself, so I will not fail. So this amount, these are real heroes. There are several others. Anyway, some other time we will see about them. What I want is you people to follow such real heroes and become real heroes yourselves. Not fall under the influence of the real heroes. Okay. Definitely you can watch for time pass and some inspiration, etc., etc. But don't fall into that. Vivekananda is such a hero. I'll just tell you about Vivekananda for 2 minutes and then I'm going to stop. Vivekananda, Gandhi, you know, Gandhi is the father of the nation. Do you know what? Why he is father of the nation? Because he was a great advocate. Why he is father of the nation? Because he loved. That formula you see. Because he was unselfish. If he was selfish, he would practice, etc. He would not think for his country. He was unselfish. Out of unselfishness came what? Love for his country. Out of love came what? Courage to do anything, right? To courage to face the British Royal Empire. And then out of courage what came? He sacrificed a lot. Out of sacrifice, he did lots of service to the country. Only then he was great. That is why we remember him still. And the whole thing is love for his country. Gandhi says, I am quoting, after reading, I have read Swami Vivekananda's works thoroughly, his life and works. After reading his life and works, the love that I had for my country became a thousandfold. And when that love for the country is the reason to become him, to become a father of the nation, that came from Swami Vivekananda, then you should call, what do you call Vivekananda? The grandfather of the godfather. Okay. Now Subhash Chandra Bose, do you know what he said? If Vivekananda was alive today, I would have been at his feet. He is my guru. Taking inspiration from him himself, from childhood, I became what I am. All my greatness comes from him, Swami Vivekananda himself. Rabindranath Tagore said, if you want to know India, read Vivekananda. In him everything is positive, nothing negative. If you just want to know India, just read Vivekananda, that is enough. That's what Rabindranath Tagore said. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan said so many things. See Rajagopalachari, anybody knows? No. Bharat Ratna, see Rajagopalachari, the first Governor General of India. He said so many things. Roma Rala, Nobel laureate, French person, he said. Hiram Maxim, anybody knows? Machine gun inventor. In America, he saw Swami Vivekananda, he said, he played with all the country's professors in America like a cat plays with a mouse. That's what Hiram Maxim said about Swami Vivekananda. There are so many other things.
we need a little more time later on, etc. Some other time we will see. So Swami Vivekananda influenced Gandhi, Subhash Chandra Bose, Anna Hazare wanted to commit suicide when he was 24. He went to Delhi railway station. The train was late on that day. And then he saw in a bookstore small book of Swami Vivekananda, his life and his mission. By the way, we have these books, some wonderful books outside. So kindly see those books. They were very nominal price, you see them. And then, you know, it life-changing books, I'll tell you how. Anna Hazare read that, and then he said, what am I going to do? I'm going to commit suicide and waste all this wonderful body and mind. Now, after reading Swami Vivekananda, I'll dedicate all my life to country's goodness. Now, from now on, my life is country's. Okay, I'm going to dedicate everything. Then he became Anna Hazare. Is it not a life-changing? Just a book. 2 pages, 3 pages. He finished whole book. Then he thought that his whole life changed. Similarly, Kiran Bedi, and so there are so many innumerable people who are inspired by Swami Vivekananda. And then I plead that you all read Swami Vivekananda. You will have lots of answers. All my questions were answered. You know, I was such a person that all my life, all my childhood, I kept on asking questions. I kept on pestering people to give me answers. Nobody could give me really. I had some answers, etc. in my mind. And then when I read Vivekananda, when I read his Guru Ramakrishna, all my answers, all my questions were answered forever. Just by one or two books. And then, you know, after that, till now I'm seeing, not one question came to me. But what question is coming? I'm trying for a good question that people cannot answer. I mean, I myself don't have answer. No. And I've answered hundreds of questions till now in my life. And I'll tell you, in the 10 years of my Ramakrishna Mission life as a sannyasi, I never regretted, not even dream, my decision to become this. And I'm happy. I don't have my bank balance. I don't know where my food comes next. Swami Vivekananda was also happy. When people saw Swami Vivekananda, they said, I've never seen a person so happy. But Swami Vivekananda was a monk, he had no bank balance, no, nothing is needed. Now do you think, for all those 5 great qualities, do you have to go to a shop and purchase Ansel Krishnas? If you go to a shop and give me 5 kilos of Ansel Krishnas, will they give? Is it not already with you? It's a treasure, it's with you, it's within you. Love is within you, courage is within you, sacrifice is within you, service is within you. You do that, you become great. It's as simple as that. You don't do that, you become ordinary. The choice is yours. Okay? So, I think in the Vivekananda Society, we will think more of these thoughts and etc. etc. We will grow. We will have real education. I'm okay with if you want a longer relationship to, again and again, some other time, etc. At one go, you may not be able to take it. Then again, we can come meet, etc. Thank you for giving me this.